Your name is Alice Standing, and yet it's Allie Standing on the cover of all the books. So how did that come to be?
Yes. So my given name is Alice, which I actually really love now, but as a kid, it felt like so old-fashioned, and all the kids called me Alice in Wonderland, which like now I would take as a total compliment. But at the time it was just like, I'm not, you know, I wanted to be my own person. I didn't want to be like a Disney character. And so when I moved into the sixth grade, I thought I needed to have a more grown-up name. And so I changed it to Allie. And that is still who I am today.
Let's talk the Mending summer. As promised, I will not summarize your book, although I do have lots of questions about it. What does esteemed audience need to know as they're putting a copy of the Mending Summer into their virtual cart right now, adding it to their library checkout list?
Yeah, so this is the Mending Summer. I love the beautiful cover, which was done by Sarah J. Coleman. It is about a 12-year-old girl named Georgia, who is living in a family that has been impacted by alcoholism. So her father is an alcoholic, and his addiction has gotten worse in the time leading up to the beginning of the novel. And so Georgia's mother decides that it would be best to send her away for the summer, for the weekdays, to get her out of the house so that she isn't around to kind of see her father giving into this disease. And so Georgia is sent off to stay with her great aunt Marigold, who is quite a prickly figure, kind of solemn figure that Georgia doesn't know very well. It's just an extended family member who she's met a few times. And so she's really anxious about it at first, but the house is mysterious and it's out in the country and she loves nature. So she starts to relax into this new setting. And as she's exploring the woods behind the house, she discovers a lake and meets a friend named Angela at the lake. And together they discover that this lake seems to have a magical ability to grant wishes. And so, of course, George's first instinct is, I can use this magic to fix my father, and to, you know, to bring him back to the person he was before the alcoholism took over. But the lake does not work that way. There are rules and boundaries to its magic that she and Angela explore together over the summer as she gets to know her Aunt Marigold. And when she's going home on the weekends, things are still continuing to get worse with her dad. And as they do, things at the lake start to change too. There's a new character who shows up, a boy named Blake, who seems to want to take the magic in a darker direction. And so this strand of magic that Georgia has discovered and what's happening in her home life come together and kind of collide in a way that leaves her with a choice for how she wants to move forward with her life and with her relationship with her father.